Tommy, that assassination attempt means that Morello has openly declared war on us. We have to deal with him. If Morello didn't have accomplices with the politicians and other important city organizations, our forces would be nearly equal. If we liquidate those people, our opponent will be a lot weaker.
That's exactly what we gotta do. Eliminate his strong contacts.
Right. And as we all know, an all-out war must be avoided. Get the generals. Then the soldiers will give up without a fight. So this is what we'll do. We'll finish them off one by one.
What do you mean exactly?
The first in line is the city councilor who's caused us so much trouble. Morello got him into politics, and that makes him a big supporter. We'll take care of him after the boy, and I mean today.
The counselor is celebrating his birthday and has decided to throw a huge shindig. He's having it on a steamboat with fireworks and the whole nine, and he'll be making a speech to the paparazzi. There'll be a lot of people there who won't do dick against us when they see what happens to him.
It sounds pretty risky.
But well worth the risk. Vincenzo knows the plan.
Okay. As I said, it's on a steamboat. It won't be easy to get in without an invite, but I know you can do it, Tom. Above all, try not to raise suspicions before we reach our goal. Of course, you won't get a weapon past the security, but I've dealt with that already. As soon as you get on deck, go to one of the men's rooms. There'll be a small revolver hidden there. Afterwards, just wait outside a while. The counselor will probably be hiding in his cabin, but he'll be out for the start of the celebration and his speech. That's your big shot. During the speech, you're gonna pop him, Tom. It's got to be in public, and this speech is the best opportunity. There'll be a big crowd there, so you can blend in with it once this thing is all done.
And then what? I'd like to get back to shore in one piece.
Afterwards, it'll be nuts. There'll be some security guards on a boat, and you should be able to get past them in the chaos. If not, get to the bow, and Paulie will pull up in a boat and bring you back safely.
So what, Tommy? It won't be a picnic, but you should pull it off.
Okay. I'll do it.
The boat is anchored on the waterfront on Central Island. You better get going or you'll miss it. Keep an eye on the time.
Buona fortuna, Tom.
Well, here we go again, Ralphie. Today I need something for one use, because we don't know how it's going to work out.
Hey, Tommy. That's no big problem. I have here this little number. They're pretty popular these days. Also, they're pretty solid. Look how easy they are to nab.
Yeah, great, Ralphie. That should do the trick.
Thank you. What a wonderful boat he has.
Unfortunately, we can't serve the crew.
Did you see that hunk of Mr. Steele?
Typical. This has to happen to me.
Did you see that dame with John?
Oh, my stomach.
This rocking is making me queasy.
Bring her out like this?
He's signing his life.
Hey there. Do you know where the key's out of that broken John?
Sorry, but I don't have a clue.
Hey there. Do you know where the key's out of that broken John?
Don't bug me. I have a lot of work to do.
Hey, I kind of need those keys. I left something there.
Yeah, right. Maybe I'll lend them to you, but you gotta promise to clean up that mess in there and bring them right back. I'll wait in the stern for you.
Clean up? Sure. You bet.
Okay, there you go. But bring them back. See how easy that was? You ain't so bad. You could open a cleaning firm.
Yeah. And I'll use you as the rag.
I'd like another coffee.
Hello there, John. I hope you're enjoying yourself.
Good evening. Yes, it's lovely here.
How are you? I hope you like it.
Thanks. We're glad to be here.
I'm glad you could make it.
It's wonderful. Thank you.
I think it's time.
So am I. The last time I saw one of these, I was 8 years old. We had some school trucks that set fire to us moments of rockets.
Like this.
You should have seen how many firemen there were there.
I tried the best I could, even in the worst of times. I always said, with integrity, man will go farthest. And that motto has lasted till today. Later on, when things were starting to go well, I got married to my darling Agnes. Unfortunately, that terrible war came into our lives. It was a dreadful time, but we got through it alive and healthy. My darling wife and I could look forward to a victory for our beloved country. Shortly after the war, my one and only son was born. Though the times weren't easy, we did quite well. We brought our son up to be a model American and instilled in his mind the principles of being a good Christian, even as...